是耶不老师。
Praise the name of Jesus. We are so delighted that you have just watched Kingdom Impact Production. That is right. This is your host, Dr. Kilafu Kali, and we are from Kingdom Apostolic Ministries International here in beautiful Freeport, Grand Bahama. We are exploding. God has truly blessed us. We are live and we are on the air. We are determined to take this gospel of the kingdom. And when this gospel of the kingdom, Jesus said, is preached to the ends of the earth as a witness unto all nations, then the end will come. We believe we have a great responsibility here at Kingdom Apostolic Ministries in preaching, teaching, worshiping, and prophetically declaring this gospel around the world. Lives are being transformed. People are being delivered, healed, and transforming their personal lives. We have so many testimonies. Thank you for watching us. Please tune in to your regular station or on our online platform. All the information will be given to you to contact us, to go on our website, to buy products from our wonderful store and list of teaching. We love you in Jesus' name. We kindly ask you to pray for us, to intercede for us, to stand in the gap with us as we work together as God's people, to touch one life at a time until we reach the world. We have a passion to reach the entire globe. I know we can do it. God has given us the mandate to do it. Thank you again for watching Kingdom Impact Production. Dr. Kilafu Kali, Kingdom Apostolic Ministries here in Freeport. We love you and we bless you in Jesus' mighty name.
The Lord. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Amen. So good to be back in the house of the Lord another day. Amen. So good to see all of you. Thank you, Prophetess Shalema. Amen. Thank you for leading us into intercessory prayer and worship. Amen. I'll give everyone a minute just to settle in. Amen. And amen. Good to see my wonderful mother-in-law. That sounds good. Amen. Amen. That sounds good. Amen. Amen. Come on, put your hands together for my wonderful mother-in-law. Amen. Paula, Sister Paula Williams. Amen. Put your hands together for her this morning. Amen. It's so good to see you. We went somewhere and in one of the stores. And the lady said, oh, congratulations. I said, thank you. And then she said, oh, your sister was here the other day. Amen. I said, who's sister? She meant you. I said, that's not her sister. That's her mother. Amen. But that's how young she looks, amen? So we thank God for keeping you young and strong, and may the Lord continue to keep you healthy and strong, amen? Amen. And my new grandmother, amen? Amen. Sister Singh, amen?
Amen.
Amen. Put your hands together. Let's bless the Lord for her. So glad to have you here for these months and celebrating with us and just being with your family and all of us as your family. So good to have you. Amen, here in your presence. So thank God for keeping you healthy and strong to be here during the season for us. Amen. Amen. The Brown family. Amen. Put your hands together for them. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, bless the Lord for all of them. My God, I'm not even going to get into the names. Amen. Because we're going to get in trouble, my dear friends. Amen.
Yeah.
We thank God for them this morning and them being here. Turn your Bibles to Revelation chapter 1. Amen. He's going to open it up so you can be a little bit more comfortable. you know, these things act up when they're ready. Amen? Good thing it is, it's nice and cool. Just open it up as wide as you can. Maybe open a little bigger. The bigger one. Okay. Is that all right? Get a little cooler for you. Amen. So good to have us here. My darling wife. Mother. I so appreciate her life and ministry. First of all, to the Lord and also her support to me and everything we're doing. It's such a delight to have her. Amen. Good woman of God. I thank God for her. Amen.
Amen.
She prayed much and prayed hard. Amen. So we have a real enemy. But we kept praying and we keep praying. Amen. We keep praying. We keep praying. We keep praying. We keep declaring over each other. We keep speaking over each other. Amen. We keep ministering to each other. We keep encouraging one another. Amen.
Amen.
And that's what God has given us. In your Bibles to Revelation 19. Amen. As we continue to press.
This is the end of the year. This is the end of 2015. We're wrapping up. We are close, but yet far. Amen?
Amen.
Yesterday, a gentleman came and said he had to go to a scene where someone had a sudden death. And as I was approaching the hospital yesterday, someone also came and said, oh, this person who you know had a sudden death. I thought it was the same thing. It was two people with sudden death. So we are close to the end of the year, but we are yet so far. You know, and that is sobering. It brings us to a place where we realize, my God, what is this life? Amen? What is this life? This life is just a vapor. You're here, and then you can be gone. And the only thing that we can carry on is what we do for Christ will last. And every time death happens, I'm reminded of that. Only what you and I do for Christ will last. Touch your neighbor and say, only what we do for Christ will last. You know, all of these things we pursue in life, it's just the use, you know. These clothes are just the use, amen? When you finish with them, you throw them away or they tear up or you give them to someone else. They use for a short period of time. The vehicle is just to use. The house is just to use. The money, all the things, all the influence God gives us, it's just to use it for His glory, to help someone out in their faith with the Lord. Amen? That's what this is about. Helping others as we travel in our journey with the Lord. Amen? Because other than that, this means nothing. If the Lord comes, He will meet us and catch us up in the air to be with Him, and we'll rule and reign with Him forever. Say forever. I want you to encourage yourself. Hey, amen. Don't get too caught up in the Christmas holiday. Amen. What you can buy, and what you can't get. Alex, sit up. What you can get, you can get. What you cannot get, don't worry your head over it. Amen. This is the time of the year when it's supposed to be the happiest. But do you know that during the Christmas holidays, the time you have the most depression? You know that's the time when most people are suicidal. Amen. Why? The pressure of trying to live and compete with other people.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. And as for our household, we're going to just wait on God. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to see what God blesses us with. And if we don't get what we want this Christmas, that's fine. Amen. Once you have family, amen? Sometimes we put more value on things, amen? Or don't go in expenses. Don't stress your husband with things to buy. Don't stress your wife with all of the preparation for the holiday. You add unnecessary stress. I want you to use wisdom, amen? Do what you can, amen? If you could just write your family members a card, amen? Children, if you could just write your mama and dad a card for Christmas, or you could do a little drawing or do something nice. Say, Mommy, Daddy, I'm going to just clean the house for you for Christmas. Amen? It's not all about money. Touch the neighbors. It's not all about money. Sometimes it's just about what you can do. Amen? Just tell them you appreciate them. Tell them you value them. That worth more than money.
And so we want you to stay focused, amen, as we close this year. Why? Because during this time, we get ready to pray, people of God, because we want to hear what God has to say, woman of God, amen? We want to hear what God has to say, but the activities of the year could make you get so busy you don't hear what God is saying. What should you and I be doing? We should be preparing our hearts to hear what the Lord is going to say for 2016, amen? Hallelujah. What do I mean? What is he saying for your family for 2016? What is he saying about your path of life for 2016? Young people, what is he saying for your career and your education and your future for 2016? What is he saying, families, about your finances? Where do you want to be next year this time? Amen. What do you want to do? Where is he taking you spiritually? Where do you want to be spiritually? What did I do this year? 2015, if I pray just 10 minutes this year, I want to pray 30 minutes a day next year. Amen. If I read the Bible for just 10 minutes this year a day, I want to be reading it for an hour a day next year. Amen. If I, hallelujah, I missed church all this year, in 2016, I want to be faithful to the house of God. Hallelujah. Whatever you are supposed to get better in 2016. Amen. Hallelujah. Touch your name and say, I'm going to get better. You got to get better. If I was shy to serve in the house of the Lord in 2015, in 2016, I should not be ashamed to share my testimony with my neighbor and my friends and my co-workers. Hallelujah, my city, or wherever I go. What else we do? Put it on Facebook, put it on Twitter, Instagram, whatever social media, whatever I was afraid to do this year, I should be better next year. I want you to get in this verse. Say, I'm going to touch yourself and say, I'm going to be better in 2016. Amen. What is your health goals? Amen. Hallelujah. We ate all kind of things this last year. But 2016, we cutting out that junk. Amen. Oh, the church went quiet. I said we ate all type of junk and chocolate and cookies and all kind of fast food. How many of you know God wants you healthy with your health like too? Amen. Yeah. The Lord is concerned about your health. He's concerned about what you even down to what you eat. Amen. So, amen. Hey, we ate all kind of junk. Hallelujah. Our goal is to lose 10, 20 pounds next year. I said amen.
Amen.
Know you not that your body is the temple of the Lord? We only use that when we want to say drinking, smoking, and sex. But it's also what you put in. I got to watch what I eat. Amen. Hallelujah. I like cake and cookies. Amen. Hallelujah. I don't eat a lot of junk food, but amen, I can eat a half a cake, amen? Not a big one, a small one, amen? So thank God for my wife. She's been telling me, no cookies, amen? No candies. And I've been telling her, yeah, no soda for you, amen? Ah, said, no cookies for you? I said, yeah, that's true. No more fast food and pizza and chicken in the bag for you in 2016. So she said, no, we had to agree to at least once a month, amen? We gonna watch that because you need to enjoy yourself sometime. But hey, you gotta be careful. God is concerned about your health, man. We can't eat this way. Amen. If we eat this way, hallelujah, in 2 years, we'll be bigger than this house. We'll be bigger than in here. We'll have all kind of health issues. Amen. And you have to think about where we should be 5 years from now. So we gotta get the juicer. We're juicing the stuff. Amen. Come on, I'm preaching. Amen. I'm already preaching. Amen. We're talking about God's health. Above all, I wish that you would prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospers. Amen. You get the little juicer and juice your carrots and your celery and apple. Amen. Drink that healthy carrot juice. Amen. Drink your Irish moss. Amen. Drink, oh God, get your fruits, cut them up, and make smoothies for breakfast. That's all you need. Amen. You don't need that healthy, that heavy food every day. For lunch, smoothies and some nuts and fruits, amen, and some water, amen. For dinner, you have your baked meat, amen. You take all that skin off, amen. You don't deep fry the thing, amen. Amen. You change your diet. Touch your name and say, change your diet.
Change your diet.
Amen. Hallelujah. You weren't exercising this year? I know you got to get outdoors, amen. Amen. Get out. Even if you walk around the house in the yard 30 minutes a day. Amen. Just walk. Amen. You don't have to go to the gym. Just walking will cut your pressure down. Will cut your cholesterol. Will regulate your blood sugar. And you live longer and healthier. Amen.
Amen.
God is no fool. Amen. God wants us prosperous. Amen. In 2016. Amen. He wants you off some of that medication. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, I'm prophesying already. God wants you off some of those medication.
Amen.
But you got to abide by health principles. Amen. You got to say, God, give me the wisdom. What I need to drink. What I need to eat. What I need to put in my body to nourish my body. What do I need to do? Amen. We're going to talk about some of that. Some of you is stress. You take on more than you need to. Amen. Touch your neighbor and say, stop stressing out.
Stop stressing out.
You stress about everything. Amen. That's not God's will for your life. We stress about too many little things. As long as you and I live, there can be bills. Why worry about bills? They come in whether you want it or not. Amen. Every day bills are coming. Why worry about bills? If God kept the light on before, what make you think he can have the lights turned off now?
Yes.
If God paid the bills when you didn't have no money, what make you think he can pay it now?
Amen.
Come on, don't doubt him. Touch your neighbor and say, stop doubting God. Amen. You never been hungry yet. Some of you, amen. If God don't provide money for food for 2 months, you'll still be fluffy. Amen. Hallelujah. If God don't provide a single morsel of bread for you, you have enough and meat on you to last you for months.
Yes.
And you wouldn't starve to death.
That's right.
God has never allowed you and I to go hungry. Never. And if you did, it was a short period of time. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. But even if you had water to drink, amen, you could go 40 days actually just drinking water. Amen. And live. Amen. So you had even access to water. Even if you had to go and borrow it from your neighbor and get a gallon to drink and boil it, you had something.
Yes.
Even if you had coconut to eat. Some fruit out your yard. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Even if you could just go down to the bay, throw a line over and catch some fish. Amen. Hallelujah. Get some coconut. Get some dilly. Get some banana. Hallelujah. God is faithful. That's my point.
Yes.
So set your goals now. And so this month, I don't want you getting carried away. Sit with your family and say, what are our goals for 2016? What do we believe God is saying for 2016? Where are we going as a family? Where are we going as a couple? Where are we going as a church, as a ministry? Where are we headed? And that's how you see the glory of God. Amen? If you don't have a plan, God can't work out with nothing, mama. Amen? God needs a plan. Touch your neighbor and say, God needs a plan. The Bible said, write your vision down. Make it plain. Tell you what we did. Which day was that, honey?
Yes.
One day we sat down for 3-4 hours. Said, we're not going anywhere. We shut down the phone. We're going to sit here. We're going to develop a new vision for our lives. Amen? And we spent 3 hours developing 10 things we're going to God for the rest of our lives. We're believing Him for. Amen?
Amen?
10 points. And each one of those points, we develop what we believe in God for. And we wrote it out in detail. Amen? And we said, God, we give you this as a contract. And we laid hands on that, my wife and I. We said, God, this is where we stand. So we know where we are, know where we're going. Amen? You could do the same thing. I'm telling you this. You could do it. Go home and sit with your family. Hey, amen. We're too busy. TV and all this. You don't be successful like that. You got to stop and say, hey, now, where are we going? And the Bible said, write your vision down. Talking it is one thing. You could say, honey, we want to do this, we want to do that, all you want. It's just in the air. Not until you put that on paper. Amen. It's just in the air. It's just you talking. It's just you spitting things out. It's just you dreaming. But it doesn't become real until you put it on paper. Amen.
Amen.
If you're serious about anything, if you're serious about anything and dealing with me, let me see it on paper. Amen. If you don't have the determination to stop and put something on paper and present it, you ain't serious about your life. Come on, give God praise.
Hallelujah.
I'm telling you, amen. Get the children, every one of you young teenagers, amen, Alex, and you, SB, and all of you, amen, you all need a vision for your life. If you don't have a vision for your life, you don't know where you're going, and you won't accomplish anything significant. Amen. What do you believe in God for? Amen. I want you to stop. When you get home today, sit down. How much ever time? Turn the phone off. Turn the TV off. Get a black and white book. Get a sheet of paper and say, God, what is it you want me to do with my life? You know, most people don't have a vision for their own life.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't have a vision for your life, Satan will find one for you. If you don't have a vision, come on, give God praise. If you don't have a vision for your life, the enemy will create one for you.
Yes.
That's true. The Bible says, without a vision, the people perish. You know what I mean? If you don't have a vision, and the Bible said in Joel, write the vision down. If you don't have a vision, and you don't have it written down, you don't have it documented, guess what? The Bible says, without a vision, the people perish. You know what that word perish means? They cast off restraints. They have no limitation. They do whatever. When we have a vision, my wife and I, because we have a vision, guess what? We're going to operate within that vision. Anytime one of us go off, hey, we have a vision to accomplish. Now, a vision is different from your goals. We haven't set all our goals yet. Our vision is the reason... Our vision is what God has given us to ask Him to fulfill for our lives. If you're writing, write that down. A vision is different from your goals. I'm going to explain that to you. Your goals are different. Your goals are different. I want you to get this, people of God. This will make you successful. When you come to church, I want you to bring in your books and your pens. Amen? Sometimes we shout and preach and holler, but sometimes I want you to get this. Amen. I want you to write. Amen. Because I want you to get this now. Listen, your vision is different from your goals. Your vision is the reason or the purpose that God created you to live for this time. Get that. The reason God allowed you to live for this reason and this purpose and this time. All right? That is the vision from the Lord for your life. So, let me help us. You need to get this. Young people, if I was taught this when I was your age, I would have been further in life. But guess what? It's never too late, Mama. Mama could get this and fulfill. Hey, I like Sarah. Sarah was 90. Abraham was 99 when they had Isaac. Amen? So your life is never over. Not until you're dead, it's over. So every one of us can have a vision. You can say, what is your vision? Let me help you. This is what you do when you go home and pray. Lord, what is the reason and the purpose you have me alive? And then secondly, what do you want me to fulfill in this time that I have left? That's the simplest way I could put it. Why was I born? Now, you might get all the answers in one thing. It's going to take some time. I'm telling you why. Because you have to sit and wait from God. Hallelujah. God, why was I born? Why am I alive? Why do you have me alive now? Show me what you want me to accomplish with this life. Amen? How many are going to do that today? Just get along with God. Amen? Just get along with God and say, God, why? Why? What do you want me to do? And let me guarantee you, when you ask him, he's going to tell you. Now, what he tells you might surprise you. Because you might have your own plan for your life. What he tells you might change the friends you have. What he tells you might change the money you spend. What he tells you might change your career path. What he tells you might change the way you view life and everything related to life. Be prepared. Turn to Lena and say, be prepared.
Be prepared.
Because a man asked him that, God said, Abraham, I want you to leave your country, leave your family, leave your home, leave your business. Go to a place where I can show you. I will make you great there. When God speaks you the vision for your life, it's your vision. Touch your neighbor, says your vision.
Your vision.
Which means no one else might understand or know or even comprehend. In fact, when God really gives you a real vision from him, most people can think you absolutely nuts. Because what God is going to tell you to do is going to be bigger than your finances can pay for. It's going to be greater than your family has ever accomplished. It's going to be greater than the place of your country and your birth. It's going to be greater than everything you could possibly do. And God is going to say, I'm going to do it for you and through you. Come on, give God praise.
Amen.
God is going to give you a vision that you're going to say, God, how am I going to build this? God, how are we going to accomplish this? God, how, I can't even imagine you taking us here and there and accomplishing this. We don't have it. Every great man and woman of God that God has ever chosen had that same situation. Whether it was Abraham, whether it was Isaac, whether it was Esther, whether it was Joel, whether it was any of the prophets, when God called them, they said, who, us? Oh, I'm an unclean man. Hallelujah. I'm an unclean woman. How many know God specializes in taking the imperfect and using them? Amen? He said his strength is made perfect in our weakness.
Yes. You know the problem in the church? We look for perfect people. God don't do that.
God takes people out of the worst situations. Amen? God takes people with a hallelujah. Jabez, he said, I'm the least among my clan. Hallelujah. Hey, everyone who God called, Ezekiel, or Jeremiah, oh, who am I, Lord, that you would choose me? Oh, I'm unclean. Hallelujah. I'm not worthy. I'm not fit to be called.
Everyone God calls and makes great.
Look at the Bible. Almost all of them were imperfect. Look at David. Imperfect. Look at Solomon. Do you know Solomon is the product of an adultery? Amen. David took a man's wife, killed a woman. Amen. And the first child died. And then she had Solomon for him. And God said, that's the one I'm going to make king. Mm-hmm. Read your Bible. God can take people from nothing and make them great.
Amen. Jesus walked on the earth.
Single woman. The shame is all around the city. Amen? This girl is pregnant. Joseph was supposed to marry her. Before he went to marry her, she was pregnant. Guess what Joseph did? This is the Christmas holiday. This is what we're talking about. But we need to see the story differently. Amen? I'm talking about the glory and the kingdom and prophetic. But guess what this is? This is what he did, Mr. Brown.
Joseph knew that Mary, in the time that Mary lived, if a woman got pregnant while engaged for someone else, she was liable for death. Amen? She was liable to death. She was supposed to be stoned.
And Joseph, with his heart, said, you know what? I love Mary. I'm not going to allow her to be stoned. I'm going to cover her, but I'm going to put her away quietly so that no one knows about the situation. Amen? While he was laying down, an angel appeared to him and said, this which is done of the Holy Spirit. Say, the Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
And the Lord touched Joseph. You know what the interesting story, part of the story is? When you bring it to 2015, bring it to our life, Mr. Brown. Can you imagine being with a woman, engage, and then marry her, and she's pregnant, and you can't touch that woman? You can't touch a woman. You inherit a woman who's pregnant. You inherit a woman, now you gotta rub her feet. You gotta rub her belly. You gotta go through the morning sickness. You gotta go through the pain. You gotta go through the ache. You gotta go through the checkup. Amen. And the baby ain't yours. But you gotta look at God. Hallelujah. And he stood there with her. Amen. This woman, because God told him, when God speaks to you, it ain't always going to be easy. Sometimes we think, when God speaks something, the condition is going to be perfect. It ain't going to be always a perfect situation.
Amen.
And he walked with Mary, talked with her. I know Nighty laid next to her. Amen. She couldn't do nothing for him for a while. She carrying a baby. Amen.
Amen.
The shame, everyone know Joseph, he had to walk in the city like this. Walk around everywhere he go in the market, people talking. Boy, Joseph, yeah, the wife pregnant, dying ears. She having baby and dying ears. He had to go and tell his family, now I'm marrying this woman who pregnant. Joseph, is your baby? No. Can you imagine that? Amen. Can you imagine that? In this day, it's the same thing as it was back then today. It ain't no different. He had to stand with a woman, go to his parents and say, she's pregnant for someone else. She says the Holy Ghost, I still can marry her. all his cousins and his uncle and his aunties and the whole family was waiting for a wonderful wedding now. Think the man gone crazy. Then you know people, they gonna talk. Everywhere they go in the store, everywhere they go in the market, everywhere they go around, people sipping. Little did they know, she was carrying the Messiah. She was carrying the Savior of the world. What am I saying? Every time God blesses and moves, it is not always going to be the perfect situation. God took an imperfect situation and made it perfect. How did Jesus come? Hallelujah. You know the story. He was born in a place where they didn't have any more hotel rooms. Can you imagine that, bro? You taking your wife who's pregnant, you go to a place, no more hotel in Freeport. The only place they have is Mina's Farm. You gotta read the story. He went there, gone, they put him in a stable. You know the stable is a barn. Yeah. Hallelujah. In those days, the Bible scripture said they didn't have these nice wooden barns. They used to put under the hotel, they used to have a little cave. That's what the Bible described it as. When they went into a little cave, and there it is where the horse and the cows and the goat would eat in that little rock thing where they put the hay. That's where the Jesus was laid. They'd have swaddling clothes. This sounds nice. They were just leftover pieces of cloth that were in there, maybe for cleaning. He was wrapped in. So in there all night while she was delivering, you hear the cows mooing. You hear the horses neighing. You hear the sheep bleeping. Hallelujah. You smell the manure and you smell the wretched smell of the animals. And in the midst of that, that's where the Savior was born. That's where they slept all night till morning and however long they were there. Amen?
Amen.
What am I saying? God could take the most imperfect things and get glory out of it. Come on, give him praise. Come on, give him praise. God can take the worst situation and make it glorious. That's why I tell people, don't give up on people yet. Once a man or woman have God, don't give up on them yet. Because God can get a hold of them and make something wonderful. Hallelujah. In the church, we like to throw people away. But you give a man or woman an opportunity in God, be careful. Because that person, you don't know what God will do. Amen. So Revelations talk about this. Talking about the kingdom, the glory. Amen. Verse 1. Hallelujah. We're talking about Jesus. I'm talking about today, Jesus. And I'm talking about the prophetic. All of that I said this morning is prophetic. Get your life ready. Something big is about to happen in your life. It doesn't matter what it looks like now. One word from the Lord, one miracle from the Lord can change your whole situation.
Amen.
Oh, y'all hear me? I said one word from the Lord can change your whole situation.
Amen.
You know that one phone call from one person can change your whole life?
Yes.
I live like that. I live for miracles. Amen. I expect one phone call to come true and say, mama, go to your bank and withdraw. Mm-hmm. I'm listening for one call. Say, hey, I have one. Come to my office and sign this contract. Or one call. Say, hey, we need you to come. Do you know that God can move suddenly like that? Come on, I ain't hearing you this morning.
Yeah.
I'm trying to build your faith. Some of you so beaten down with life. You've gone through so many hard things. It's even hard to believe. I will get out of a one-room apartment and God's going to put me in a house. You've been struggling for so long, you can't believe God to give you a vehicle debt-free.
Yes.
You've been sick so long, you used to taking medication. You've been tormented for so long, you've gotten used to being depressed and suicidal and psychotic. You struggle so long, you expect bad things to happen to you. In fact, when you get up in the morning, you don't expect to see a miracle. You expect God, how he'll make it through another day. You're so used to bad things happening. Amen. But the Lord want to break that curse of your life. He want to change your mindset. You need to start moving in the blessings of God. You're so used to being without.
You're so used to living from day to day, it's difficult to see your cupboards filled.
Hallelujah. You're so used to penny picking. I can pay this bill, $2 or not, 50 cents on this one, a dollar now. You're so used to being afraid that they're going to cut the water, they're going to cut the light. You're so used to the landlord coming, and you got to make 10 different promises, ducking this way, ducking that way. It's difficult
for you to see God. Give you your own business,
that one day you will be the landlord. Hallelujah. It takes a change of mind, but you gotta have the faith to believe.
Amen.
Yes. Amen. It's not you. You can never do it on your own.
It's through the Lord. Amen. So we come back to this word here. See, in Revelation now, John began to write, he said, and after these things, I heard a great voice of much people in heaven saying what? Hallelujah, salvation, glory, and honor, and power unto the Lord our God. Revelation chapter 19, verse 1. Everyone get that. I want you to read that. I want you to hear that. Amen? And after these things, I'm going to read it again. Read. I heard a great voice of much people in heaven. Stop there. How many of there? Many people in heaven.
See the Bible, but they will never see this. Because why? They blocked on us. Because their doctrine is demonic.
But it says here, I heard a great voice of many people. It didn't say angels. Many people.
Yeah. Now, when the Bible talks of people, it describes it in Revelation. Thousands and thousands and thousands of thousands and hundreds of thousands. Because they didn't know about million and billion and trillion. They didn't have those words. So they said thousands and thousands of thousands and thousands of thousands.
Heaven is filled with many people. The world right now has 6 billion people. And they believe that a quarter of the world's population are believers. If my math is right, amen, how much would that be? 1.5 billion. And that's just in our time. How many went before us? You think heaven can just have 144,000 people? You've got to be crazy. Hallelujah. All types of billions of people from Adam to now who worship God, all of Israel, all of the saints that went on before us.
And only 144,000? I might as well live like hell now. If only 144,000, because I'm sure some better people have gone in than before me.
Amen? If it was based on goodness, I'm sure there were some good, innocent children who never sinned and had no understanding of sin. They didn't take up the sports. If that's the case, but it's not the case, because the Bible said, I heard a great voice of much people in heaven saying what? Hallelujah! Salvation and glory and honor and power unto the Lord our God.
The first point is, when you talk about the glory,
the kingdom and prophetic,
if you hate worship down here, you're going to have a miserable time in heaven. I'm sorry.
If you have difficulty lifting your hand and worshiping heaven, it's going to be a culture shock for you. If you have difficulty when the worship is played, lifting your hands and worshiping God, you see all these dead religious organizations who make fun of people who worship God with song and music and shouting. The Bible says, shout out to God. Pour the trumpet. Sound the alarm. Worship him with the string instruments. Worship him with the song.
Sing
unto the Lord. Whether you use CD, whether you use a live praise and worship team, whether you use an orchestra, whether you're just using tambourine and then your hands and your voices, it doesn't matter. Worship the Lord. Yeah. If you will get anything in 2015 and 2016, you got to be worshipers. Amen. Some people think folk just got everything. No, you don't know how much people worship. Amen. Amen. We build our life on worship. All of these things God has blessed me with is through worship. Amen. Hallelujah. And I don't need to worship in church only. Amen. Sometimes I'm in my car worshiping. Sometimes I'm home worshiping. Sometimes, hey, wherever I am, I'm worshiping. When he tells me to worship, I worship him. And hallelujah. Worship gets the attention of God.
Amen.
Come on, shout glory.
Glory.
Take a second and worship him. Come on, take us. Come on, worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory and honor, dominion and power be unto our God forever. Right, come on, worship him. Some of you need a miracle. You need to worship the Lord. Hallelujah. What is worship? Worshiping is doing what is in heaven and bringing down to the earth. That's bringing the kingdom of God.
Hallelujah.
Some of the things you have, you
You will never be able to get it on your own. You know the only way you're going to get it? When you worship God. Some miracles you need, you ain't gonna never save up enough money to get that miracle. You need to worship God. Some healing in your body, you need to worship God. Some oppression in your mind, you need to worship God. Some financial breakthrough, you will never save up enough to get it. You need to worship God. Some things you need to see in your family, you need to worship God for it. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Worship. When you worship God, you know what happens? You do what is in heaven on earth.
Yes.
That's bringing the kingdom of God to the earth.
Yes.
Jesus said, let thy kingdom come.
Yes.
Let thy will be done. Where? On earth as it is in heaven. Yes. What's happening in heaven?
Worship.
What's happening in heaven? Worship unto God. Praising him. Giving him glory and honor. Man, you can't get up in the morning and keep your mouth shut up. Hallelujah. Your mouth pin up all day. Hallelujah. You're going to work, your mouth pin up. You come home, you pin up. That's why you ain't getting nothing. Watch the people who are worshiping. Oh, thank the Lord. The Lord is good. He is wonderful. Praise the Lord. Man, you get up in the morning. Lord, I give you thanks. I give you praise. I give you worship. Hallelujah. Through the household. Getting ready. Lord, you're worthy. Lord, you're awesome. Lord, you're so wonderful. My God, you woke me up this morning. Oh, I got my eyes. I can still see. I can still breathe. My limbs are still working. Praise God. Everything. I got breath. Let me go in the kitchen. Oh God, only tea in here. I'll drink it and give you praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I got a hike ride to work, but I'm going to give you praise. I'm going to go to work. There's a nasty boss, but I'm going to give you praise. Hallelujah. I'm going to walk home, catch the bus home. However I get home, once I get home again, I'm going to praise God. I'm going to just worship him.
Glory.
We can see you and get miracles.
Yes.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Yes.
You know, I get some stuff. I learn a secret with God. I thank him for what people call the small things. I'm driving in a park and a space opened up. I give him praise. Lord, thank you. That's you. Hallelujah. That's what worship means. Recognize him in all things. And all things, acknowledge him. And he will direct your path. My God, you go in the cupboard and you see an extra noodle in the back there. Praise God. I didn't see this before, but I found it. My God, you go in the car and you get an extra pair of socks. Praise God. Hallelujah. Yeah. You go to work and someone says, man, I'm treating you to this hot potty. Oh, my God, it's God. Recognize him in everything.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
You walk into the car, almost hit you, and it's swerved out of the way. Give him praise. Don't cuss him. Mother, this and that, that, that. No. You thank him.
Hallelujah.
Recognizes him. So worship unto the Lord. You give him praise for everything. Someone blesses you with something, you give him thanks. Man, you praise him. Something good happened. Hallelujah. Amen. Don't just go on and act crazy and act like it ain't God. Amen. Something tell me this. Something tell me that. What does this something tell you? Amen. The Lord tell you go through that corner. When you drive by, you see a car. When you come back around, you see a car accident. Hallelujah. You know it's God. Something tell me go through that corner. No, you know something is the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. He told you go this way because an accident was about to happen that way and it spared your life. You but something. Don't mess with God. Tell him it's him. Lord, it's you. You told me don't go through there. Now I'm spared. Lord God, you told me don't make that call and I was spared. Lord God, you told me not to go here or you told me to go there and I saw your favor.
Yeah.
Worship. Do I have any worshipers? For true and righteous are his judgments. Amen. For he had judged the great whore, which did corrupt the earth with her fornication, and had avenged the blood of his servants at her hand. Oh my God, that's another piece there. Let me tell you something. God is going to judge and avenge every blood of every believer that was shed. Amen. Come on, I even get that later. Amen. Hey, if you live for Christ, your blood, God is going to protect. Amen. He's going to protect you. Hallelujah. He's going to keep you. Amen. Everything about you, he loves. Verse 3. And again, they said, what they said? Hallelujah. And a smoke rose up forever and ever. Verse 4. Revelation 19:4. Read loud. And the 24 elders. And the four beasts fell down and worshiped God that sat on the throne saying, amen, hallelujah. Again, it's worship. My God, oh, heaven is filled with worship. You better open your mouth and worship. You got to connect with heaven and worship. Hallelujah. Some of these religions want you not to worship. No, that ain't worship. You know how I know that ain't worship? I used to think it was so holy just like, hallelujah, amen. Until I saw how we carry on for football games, and see how we carry on for Lakers, and see how we carry on for Dolphins, and how we carry on for the Golden Knights, how we carry on for Usain Bolt. Hallelujah! Yeah! Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa! We worship man more than we worship God. Can you imagine how jealous God is sitting in heaven? We shout for Kobe Bryant when he make a shot. We shout for the hallelujah. Levan Sands when he jumps. We shout for Price when she runs or Bolt. We shout, oh God, for Powell. We shout for all of these people who are mortal men who can't save us, who can't deliver us. And then we become the house of God. We shut down God. And God is sitting there, okay. Let Kobe save you then. Let 70 to 5 deliver you. Let Debbie Ferguson bring you victory. Let Usain Bolt open up doors for you there. Since you won't give him all glory to me, then let him bring you deliverance. That's what it is. Now I'm not saying no shout for your teams. But if you're going to shout for your team, then you should shout for the Lord greater. Shout for the Lord right now. Let me see if you got it.
Jesus.
Oh yeah, you ain't got that. I can say it again. Shout for the Lord. Let me see if you're really catching this message this morning. Come on, give praise to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Jesus. Now you shout for your team better than that. Come on, come on, come on. When you get a new trouble, yeah, we got God. We got God. Hey, bum, 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 bum. Blow on your horns.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Then the one who saved you, deliver you, you expect to feed you, clothe you, protect you every day. Hallelujah. Jesus, Jesus. Let me try this one more time. Let me rehearse this for heaven one more time. I ain't gonna tell you what to do, but if I were you, I'd jump up on your feet. I would shout, I would dance, yes. I would carry on like you just won $1 million. Come on and give God praise! Hallelujah! Oh, yes, Lord! You are worthy! You are worthy! We praise your name. Let the nations hear our praise. Let our praises go to the ends of the nations. Let our praises go from city to city. Let it ascend to heaven. And we declare our God reigns. Hallelujah. Come on, praise him. Come on, praise him. You don't gotta be silent this Sunday. Hallelujah. I give you permission to shout in this building. Hallelujah. You are worthy, Lord. We give you praise. There is no one like you, Lord. There is no one like you, Lord. There is no one like you, Lord Jesus. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. There's none that compares to you. Righteous. Holy. Wonderful. Is our God. And the devil can stay in hell. Hallelujah. Jump on your feet. You all better get at this. Alex, lift up your hand and you praise God. You need deliverance. Lift up your hands and shout unto God. Stand to your feet, young man. And worship the Lord. We're going to lift up worship in this place one more time. Open your mouth and shout hallelujah. Shout glory. Shout Jesus. Give him praise. Glory. Hallelujah. Wonderful is our God. Awesome is our God. Amazing is our God. We give you worship, Lord. From the sun to the setting of it. Your name is to be praised.
Yes.
Worship, worship. Worship him, worship him. Worship him, worship him. Come on, y'all people, worship him. Come on, saints, worship the Lord thy God. Him alone deserves your worship. Hallelujah. We don't worship man. We worship the living Savior. We don't worship a sports team. We don't worship a prime minister. They will fail you. Your president will fail you. Your prime ministers will fail you. Your government and your cabinet will fail you. The only one that will sustain his word and make miracles for you is the everlasting Elohim, the everlasting God. His name is Jesus the Christ. Your job will fail you. You will fail yourself. But he alone is worthy. He alone deserves the glory. He alone deserves the praise. He alone deserves the worship. I don't care who is for you or who is against you. If you have the Lord on your side, you have all of heaven with you. Hallelujah. The hell with who don't like you. The hell with who left you. Hallelujah. God is with you. And you and God and your worship can touch heaven for miracles. He is worthy to be praised. He is worthy to be worshipped. He is worthy to be adored. He is righteous. He is holy. And your praises will touch his heart. Your praises will release miracles to you. Your praises will bless you. Your praises will cause his hand to be extended towards you. Hallelujah. Whatever you need for, don't look to a man, a woman, a boy, a girl. You get in a place, you worship him, and after you worship him, you say, Father, release your blessing upon me. Whatever you need, Lord, release the food today. Lord, I need a job. I'm going to worship you until my job comes. Lord, I need a miracle. I'm going to worship you until my miracle comes. You need a job. Lift up your hands and begin to worship. You who need a miracle in your family, lift up your hand and worship. Hallelujah. I won't be stopped, but I'm a worshiper. I won't be restricted because I'm a worshiper. You can't stop me in this life because I got a key and it's called worship. Oh, you can't put me down because I got a key. It's called worship. Oh, you can't discourage me because I got a key. It's called worship. I can't be depressed because I got a key. It's called worship. Oh, I won't have any more sleepless nights. I got a key and it's called worship. Somebody clap your hands, stomp your feet and give him praise. Come on, worship him, worship him. Come on, worship him. I got a key, it's called worship. Hallelujah. I don't need a word from a man because as I worship, the Lord is doing it now. Hallelujah. As you worship the Lord, he is doing something now. Come on, all the children, everybody clap your hands unto the Lord. Come on, clap those hands and shout. Come on, clap those hands, clap those hands. Come on, come on, come on, praise him. Come on, just for 60 more seconds, give him a praise. Come on, praise him like you've never praised him before. Come on, bless him like you've never blessed him. Come on, worship him like you need a miracle. Shout your voices, stomp your feet, shake your hands, and give him praise until you feel your miracle right through. Oh Lord, we worship. Oh Lord, we worship. We worship you. We worship you. We don't worship a man. A man can't help us. Oh God, oh Lord, only you, God, have brought the victory to us. Come on, worship. Come on, 30 more seconds. Come on, 30 more seconds. We worship you. We worship you. We came outside. We worship you. Lord. Hallelujah. Glory, honor, dominion, power, praise and might be unto our Lord. Shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. Jesus. Hallelujah. I want you to do something. I want you to do something prophetic. I want you right now, just listen to me for a minute. I got a word instruction from the Lord. I want you to get 2016 on your mind. I want you to get every miracle that you didn't get. God still is able to do it before the end of the year. I believe God is going to do some things before the end of the year as we shout and worship Him this next 60 seconds. If you need to get out of your seat, if you need to get out of your chairs, all of y'all, everybody, I want everyone doing it. Get out of this room, woman of God, just play something else. Great and mighty, just play that same one. I want you to get out of your chair. I want you to get 2015. All the hell we went through this year, I want you to worship. All the struggle you went through this year, I want you to get 2016 on your mind, and I want you to think about every miracle you believe in God for. Some of you want a change of job. Some of you need an economic and a financial breakthrough. Some of you are going to shout and praise God for a lost loved one, a family members who need miracles. You need something from the Lord. The Lord said, as you, when I sounded an alarm on the count of three, I want you to get out of your seat, and I want you to worship Him like He has the answer for you. And even as you worship, even now the Lord is going to move on your worship. He's going to move on your prayer. He's going to move on your praise. Get on your feet. Get all around this room. One, get ready to worship. Two, get ready for your mouth. Three, give Him praise. Hallelujah. Great and mighty, oh God. Mighty is our God. Lord, we worship You. Hey, hallelujah. All glory, honor, dominion, and power. Praise be unto our God. Oh, we worship You as we close out 2015, as we prepare for 2016. We worship You. Oh, Lord, for Your many miracles in 2015. Oh Lord, oh, for all that You're about to do in 2016. Lord, we lift up a shout. Lord, we lift up a praise. Lord, we lift up worship unto You. Lift up your hands all around this room as I pray. Come on, worship Him. Everyone stand to your feet. Lift up your hands. Lift up your hands. The Lord is moving. Come on, all of you. Stand up. Stand up. Stand up. Don't miss God. Lift up your hands. Lift up your hands. Lift up your hands. Oh, the power of God is releasing this house. The Spirit of the Lord is moving in this place. Come on, lift up your hands and worship Him. As you lift up your hands, the rain of God's presence is falling. I declare every yoke is broken in the mighty name of Jesus. Come on, lift up His hands. Help Him, help Him, help Him. Help Him, lift up His hands. Someone go grab Him, mama. Lift up those hands. Lift them up. The power of God is here. Deliverance is taking place. Stand, stand, stand in the presence of the Lord. Lift up your hands. And as the Lord is moving, we break every yoke. We break every chain. We break every whip. Hey, we break every tormenting spirit. Lift up your hands. We break every struggle, every battle in the name of Jesus. Lord God, I release the fire of the Lord. I release the glory of the Lord. I release the anointing of the Lord to break every yoke. I release the blessing of Abraham. I release the favor of God. I release the glory of God upon this house. Lift up your hands. Here's the anointing. I release the anointing of the Lord that destroys every yoke. We command every demonic spirit broken. We need to command every power of hell broken. We command every yoke destroyed. We command every yoke to be destroyed because of the anointing. We loose every power of hell in the name of Jesus. He set his mind free. Release the blessing.
I'm so delighted that you took the time with your family and your loved one to tune into this broadcast, Kingdom Impact Production. We have been doing all we could to get this gospel of the kingdom out. I pray that this message really transform your heart, that you would spend some time today reflecting on it. You will go to your Bible and go through and study what was taught and really implement those things. The Lord has a great purpose for your life. We are standing with you. Here at Kingdom Apostolic Ministries, we request your prayer, your financial support. Please visit us on our website. Please see us on the various mediums that will come up on this site. And follow us. I would love to hear from you. Please email, call, Skype me, all the methods you can. please let us know that you're with us praying for us, and be a blessing if you can. Please bless us with any donation. No donation is too big or too small. Again, God bless you. We look forward to you joining us again for another presentation. Amen.